Hello everybody, in today's video we will take a look at some concepts that are important for solar technology. We're going to look at kilowatt peak for panels, kilowatt for inverter power, and kilowatt hours for measuring energy use over time. That's used on meters and also in batteries to talk about battery capacity. So all these concepts are a way to measure things that we use with solar technology, but they are very, very different from each other. So let's start with kilowatt peak. The peak, why is that P there? Because when we talk about ratings for solar panels, that is the peak value that a panel can give out in energy when it's absolute maximum, which is not really very often. It's only actually happening in laboratories. Because optimal conditions you will never have on an installation, because you will have loss in dust and clouds and cables and inverter. So let's say a panel is 450 watts. It's never giving that output in an installation, but that's what it's rated as when it's coming from the factory. So that's why we call it kilowatt peak. That's the rating of how much the panel can give out in optimal conditions. But in normal conditions, when you have weather and angles and inverter loss and everything, a 450 watt panel is going to give maybe 370 or 380, something like that. But it's going to vary throughout the day. So it's going to start very low and go very high in the middle of the day, and then very low again in the afternoon. But it will never give 450 watts. But we have that rating on panels so that we know how much it is possible to get out of it from the technology. That's how the technology in the panel is made, and the summary of all the output it could theoretically give out in optimal conditions. Because that's really the only way that we can rate panels. It's by having a measurement of those values in optimal conditions. Once we start talking about average values and things like that, it becomes impossible to rate panels, because what is an average value? There is nothing in the industry that gives us any measurement of average values for panels. So that's why the standard has become kilowatt peak. Now, in the past, and also actually still, many people, they don't use the P, they only say kilowatt about the total rated watts on the roof. But it's much better to use the P, because then we differentiate it from the other concepts here. And so it will be much more easy to communicate if we only use the kilowatt peak about what's going on the roof, how many panels, and the total power on the roof. So that's what the kilowatt peak is. Inverter power is rated as kilowatt. So if an inverter is 5 kilowatt, it can maximum output 5,000 watts AC. So that is completely different from the value up here, which is a maximum value that you can never reach. This value that we are talking about with inverter power, the inverter can actually reach a lot and quite steady every day if you have enough panels. So that's why it's a completely different value, and that's also why it should have a different name compared to this one. It's not the same thing. So that's why when we talk about inverter power and we use the concept kilowatt, it is very different from when we use this concept kilowatt peak about panels. Okay? So then to kilowatt hours, which is a little bit complicated, because then we are looking at energy over time. And obviously, over time, energy can change. How much you use changes over the course of a day, depending on what you open and everything. That's why the use of energy will be a little bit more complicated to express in a concept. But that's why we use the kilowatt hour. So 1 kilowatt hour is the same as 1,000 watts over 1 hour. And then if you use 2,000 watts the next hour, we say that you have used 2 kilowatt hours that second hour. That's how you measure electricity over time. So another way to put it is that 1 kilowatt hour is what you need to run one medium air condition and some sockets and some fans for 1 hour. Okay? That's a different way to express it. If it gets too abstract to say 1,000 watts for 1 hour, then we can say it like that. One medium air condition and some sockets and some fans. That will usually be around 1,000 watts. But of course the values will up and down because you turn things off and turn things on. So it will not be steady. So you could be using 500 watts for half an hour and then 1,500 for half an hour. And that will also equal 1 kilowatt hour for 1 hour. So you can have all kinds of variations around this number. But it's anyway, it's a very good way to express energy use over time. And it's very easy to calculate in apps and stuff. So when you see values in solar apps and it says kilowatt hour, that's the accumulated use of energy that you have had over that time that the value is for. So it could be for a day. Like, for example, today you have used 10 kilowatt hours of energy, or it could express how much energy the solar system has produced. So that for 5 kilowatt, that could be 20 kilowatt hours. So that's an expression of energy over time. But you cannot use kilowatt peak to express that. That's not possible, because kilowatt hour takes all those variables like weather and dust and loss and everything like that and summarizes the resulting power that we actually receive. But the kilowatt peak is before we know what happens over time. It's just an abstract expression of the potential energy that could come from panels. So that's why it's very different. But once you understand the relationship between these, then I would say you are those are the most important things to understand about solar. Once you understand these things, then you're very, very okay foundation for using solar energy. So the concept that people have the most problem understanding is this kilowatt hour. We have other videos only about this concept, so you can check that also. But the main point is that it actually is an expression over time of what the energy, how much energy has been used or produced. Now, of course, we can take away the K on all this and we can say what hour, only watts, and what peak. That would be for a very small system. They don't really exist that much, but in theory, you could have a system that produces only, you know, some watts and not kilowatt hours, but watt hours. And the panels would be, you know, not measured in kilowatt peak, but in watt peak. So when we say 450 watts, that would be 0.45 kilowatt peak, you know. But the full system of 10 panels would be of 450 watts each would be 4.5 kilowatt peak. So that's how it's used. It's very intuitive once you sort of grasp the concepts. And it's the same with if you want to look at very big systems, you could then look at megawatt hours and megawatts and then megawatt peak. That you can certainly do that. And that's what they do in very big systems. So that's a small introduction to these concepts. And don't worry if you don't catch especially this one immediately. It actually becomes intuitive when you start looking at appliances over time. And most people who get solar, they will struggle with this a little bit in the beginning. But then they catch it, and then it's fine after that. So that's it, guys. Take it easy. Bye-bye.